Good morning, children. Take your English grammar book, functional English grammar and composition. Today's class is about chapter 3, kinds of nouns. Chapter 2 we have completed already. What is chapter 2? Types of sentences. I have explained you about types of sentences. First I have explained you the sentence, first chapter, how to form the sentence, what are the rules and regulations to form the meaningful and correct proper sentence. A sentence has contains what, you know, verb, and sentence always beginning of the first letter of the word is a capital letter. All these points I have explained in making the to form the sentence. Second chapter, types of sentences. Declarative sentence or assertive sentence, interrogative sentence, next imperative sentence, and then interrogative sentence. All these I have explained you and I have given the homework also. See here, you wrote a declarative or interrogative or imperative and positive sentence. And negative means what? Negative form. There is a difference between negative forms and interrogative sentence, children. Interrogative sentence ends with question mark. But negative forms we are using, no? I am reading a book. Suppose I am telling you, I am not reading a book. Not. So negative forms what we are using? NO, no, or NOT, not. According to the sentence, we have to use the negative form no or not. So I am explaining. What is negative form? I am not explaining. Okay? So interrogative sentence ends with question mark. All these points I have explained you in previous chapter. Today we have completed all these things. NO, no, where we have to use, and do not. Isn't it all these things I have explained you in today's class? Kinds of nouns, children, chapter 3 of page number 18 and 19. Kinds of nouns. How many kinds of nouns? Proper noun. Already you got in lower classes the proper noun and common noun. Common noun means there is no specific name. There is no particular name of a person. First of all, what is noun? Naming words. Name of a place or person or animal or thing, all these are called nouns. So kinds of nouns, proper noun and common noun, collective noun, countable noun and uncountable. I will explain all those things in nouns kind in further class. Today's class is about proper noun and common noun. What is called proper nouns and what is called common noun? See here, page number 18. A noun is the name of a person, place, animal or thing. Nouns can be singular or plural. Even nouns can be singular or plural. See, you have learnt about the different kinds of nouns. Already have learnt. Just we have to recollect them or recall them. See, heading proper nouns. What is called proper noun? Okay, children, see here. Nouns that are referring particular name, particular persons or particular places. Isn't it Taj Mahal? It's a particular place. Taj Mahal, it's the proper noun. Okay? And next, Sumana, first girl, isn't it? Ram, boy. And next, animals. See, all things are called proper nouns, isn't it? Proper nouns always begin with a capital letter. See, elephant is a common noun. If you give the name that name to that elephant, it is called a proper noun. Book is a common noun. If you give the name, suppose English or Telugu, Hindi, that is a proper noun. See, days of week, Sunday, Monday and all, and months of the year, January, February, March, and name of the festivals, Holi, Diwali, Dasara, isn't it Vinayaka Chauthi or Ganesha Chaturthi, all these festivals names, and next languages which we speak, English or Telugu or German or Spanish, isn't it? All these names are all these come under proper noun, children. When we give a particular name of nouns, it is called a proper noun. Okay, see here, proper nouns always begin with a capital letter. Read the sentences given below. Here there are some sentences with concern pictures also. See here, she's this girl. See, who is she? Miss Shilpi is our teacher. What is her name, children? Miss Shilpi. She is a teacher. See here, in this sentence, no, common noun is there and proper noun is there. What is common noun in this sentence? A teacher. Because there are so many teachers will be there. And see, Miss Shilpi. Here particularly, they have mentioned the name of the teacher. So, Miss Shilpi, you have observed here, they have given highlighted. These are all called highlighted words. I mean, they have given in red color. Mrs. Shilpi is the name of a teacher. This is called a proper noun. Coming to sentence B, we are going to Udaipur for a school picnic. We are going to Udaipur. Udaipur is the name of a place. Isn't it? See, it's a U capital letter. Coming to C, Jawaharlal Nehru was the first Prime Minister of our country, India. See, name of a person, Jawaharlal Nehru. Country is the name of a place, India, I capital letter. Coming to D, Ellie the elephant loves to eat the leaves of the trees. Just now I told you, elephant, elephants. See, nouns can be singular or plural children. Elephant, singular. Okay, elephants, plural. But even though if we give the name noun, Ellie the elephant is a proper noun. Coming to next picture, my sister is reading Alice in Wonderland. Alice in Wonderland is the name of a book. My sister is reading Alice in Wonderland. So you observe this highlighted words, because specific name, particular name of a person, places, animals and things. What is the thing here? Name of the book, children. So this is called proper noun. When we use, when we give a particular name, when we specify a particular name, is called a proper noun. Okay, children. Coming to page number 19. See here, in the given sentences, the highlighted words. Just now I told, highlighted means red color. See, words are proper nouns. Miss Shilpi and Jawaharlal Nehru, Udaipur and India are the name of the places. Miss Shilpi and Jawaharlal Nehru, name of a persons. Ellie, elephant. And Alice in Wonderland is the name of a book, thing. So all name of person, place, animal, things. When we give the names for these nouns, they are all called proper nouns. Now coming to what is called common noun? That is general thing. We are not specifying any name of these nouns, children. Suppose boy, teacher, isn't it? Bad, book, huh? Isn't it? All these are all called common nouns. Postman, teacher, lawyer. Which lawyer? What is the name of the lawyer? Animals. See, elephants, tigers. There is no separate particular name of these animals, isn't it? See, nouns that give a common or general. Common means what? General. How we are speaking of general? See, general name of the persons or places or animals or things are called common nouns. In these common nouns, we are not specifying any name of the nouns, children. Okay? See, read the sentences below. See, a postman brings us letters. Observe the highlighted words, children. See, what is the difference between this page highlighted words and this page highlighted words? Here specifying particular name of a place, or a person, or an animal, or a thing, children. See, postman. So many postmen will be there. And so many letters. And there were 5 cupcakes on the plate. 5 cupcakes. The cat ran after the mouse. See how the cat is chasing to catch the mouse, children. My friend will not go to school today. Friend name is not mentioned, school name is also not mentioned. So these are all common nouns. Okay, children. In the above sentences, the highlighted words are common nouns because they do not refer any name, children, particular person or place, only general. So postman and friend, persons, school, place, cat and mouse, animals, letters, cupcakes and plate are called things, children. When we are not referring any particular person name or this one, they are all called common nouns. Already we have learned, already we have done so many exercises about proper nouns and common nouns in previous classes. Once we have to recollect in this class. Okay, children, just today we have to go through these pages. Just we have to read. Okay, children, thank you.